for the presidential elections today. India is choosing its new president as elections are underway. It's NDA's Ramnath Kovind and opposition's Meera Kumar in the fray for the position of the president of the country. As we know, the BJP has the numbers and the Congress, it merely seems to be a formality. Congress President Sonia Gandhi has called the presidential polls an ideological war, urged the leaders to look into their soul, their conscience before casting their vote. It's just a matter of days now when India will get its new president, but it remains to be seen who gets the throne and who gets the disappointment. On your screens, you can see voting is underway. Visuals coming to you from across the country. Earlier today, we saw Prime Minister Modi along with BJP President Amit Shah, who did cast their ballot. As you can see on the left-hand side, on the other side, voting is taking place in assemblies all across the country. A very crucial voting process by all MPs, all MLAs, and it's going to be a very interesting fight indeed between Ms. Meera Kumar and Mr. Ramnath Kovind, who is the NDA's candidate. We have been speaking to experts as well on what this presidential post really means. We have spokespersons of the Congress as well as the BJP joining us live from the Vijay Chowk as well. But on the eve of these elections, we saw the messages that came out from Prime Minister Modi as well as Congress President Sonia Gandhi. As we know that there are many who will, of course, come out and vote. 40 parties are going to be voting in for the NDA's pick, Mr. Ramnath Kovind. So it's going to be a sweep, really, where this presidential race is concerned, and Mr. Ramnath Kovind will, in all likelihood, emerge as the winner. Talking about it from numerics point of view, the NDA has the numbers since it's been able to build a consensus amongst, of course, its allies as well as parties that are supporting Mr. Ramnath Kovind, whereas on the other side, it's only 17 parties, about 17 of them who have supported Meera Kumar. Let's take a listen into many reactions we have on these developments.
जब हम मॉनसून सत्र का प्रारंभ कर रहे हैं तो उसके प्रारंभ में ही हम देश के उन किसानों को नमन करते हैं जो इस ऋतु में कठोर परिश्रम करके देशवासियों के खाद्य सुरक्षा का इंतजाम करते हैं और उन्हीं को नमन करते हुए ये सत्र का प्रारंभ होता है.
Today is voting. I am sure Ramnath Kovindji will win with a comfortable, respectable margin.
बहुत बड़े अंतर से राष्ट्रीय जनतांत्रिक गठबंधन के प्रत्याशी और उत्तर प्रदेश के सपूत श्री राम कोविंद जी भारत के महामहिम राष्ट्रपति के रूप में निर्वाचित होने जा रहे
हैं. The president of India is occupying such a position who has to safeguard the interest of the entire nation. So he should be a person and pursue an ideology wherein everybody should be equal for him. When there's a clash of ideologies, I think our candidate is the best.
Today will be becoming the president with a decisive majority, and as he has said always, and as we know him, he is going to be a textbook president in accordance with the norms of the constitution.
दोनों में से कोई भी जीते, लेकिन खुशी की बात यह है कि सुर कास्ट का आदमी तो देश का राष्ट्रपति बनेगा. मैं समझती हूँ कि ये हमारी मूवमेंट के लिए, पार्टी के लिए ये, और बीएसपी की वजह से एनडीए को, बीजेपी को दलित वर्ग का आदमी राष्ट्रपति पद के लिए उतारना पड़ा और दूसरी तरफ से भी उतारना पड़ा.
Race that's on all across the country where voting process is underway. The stage is all set, and 2 days from now there will be the announcement, of course, on who will be the next president, the 14th president of the country. Let's go back to my colleague Gauri Dwivedi joining us live from Vijay Chowk. She has with us spokespersons of the BJP and the Congress. Gauri, please take it away.
Who will be the next president of India is now, of course, a matter of time. We know on the 20th of July, but right now, of course, the numbers are absolutely stacked in favor of Mr. Kovind. We'll get that answer from Congress as to why is this fight really happening. It's an ideological battle that has been talked about time and again, but it's a losing battle that Meera Kumar has really found herself in.
Right. Well, I think this is a marathon, not a race. I think in the longer run, for constitutional principles, history will vindicate us. These people will be, every year passes, I come more and more to the conclusion that they will be on the wrong side of history. They're a government of people who cannot govern. They are driven more by rhetoric. Slogans announced karte rehte hain. Abhi bhi campaign mode mein lage hain. Online inki alochna karo.
What has that got to do with the presidential election? Aren't you making a mountain out of a mole? The fact that they did not reach out to you once and therefore you must have a candidate of your own. The fact that you must divide the opposition. Aren't you making a mountain out of a mole?
Coming to answer your question very directly. Under the constitution, the president has the highest role. He's the supreme commander of the armed forces, yes. For God's sake. Yes. He is called upon under various articles of the constitution, yes, to arbitrate when there's a dispute between states. Yes. He is the one who makes a reference to the Supreme Court when a dispute or matter of law needs to be, yes, resolved. Now, when there is a post like this that has to be above bipartisanship, then by God, we will not let you suborn it. By God, you talk about the fact that every election in the past has been contested except for Sanjeeva Reddy's, of course. But the fact is, not in these percentages. If you have read more than the Wikipedia page on the subject, you will know that this is the highest amount of cleavage that has ever happened. This is the greatest divide. You might try to say, "Arey, wo do char partiyan, 17 partiyan aapke khilaf awaaz utha rahi hain. Wo 40% hai. Aap bhi 40% ho. You've got additional allies. But you may win this battle, but you will."
We'll have to interrupt you there for a moment because there is some more news that's coming in. We have spoken to the son of the presidential candidate, Meera Kumar, from the UPA side. Let's take a listen in to what does he have to say on this very crucial day.
Well, it's a lot of excitement inside the house because the battle and the ideology we stand for, we've seen it, we are taking that forward. And we hope that eventually that will be the battle that emerges triumphant.
If you talk about numbers, you know, the suddenly is completely in the favor of Mr. Ramnath Kovind, who is the BJP's vision candidate. So how do you describe this whole, you know, battle? Do you also consider, as you know, Congress President Sonia Gandhi said, this is the ideological battle, not the you know, battle of merely numbers?
Absolutely. I mean, the Congress president articulated our position in the best way possible. It is a ideological battle, and if it was a battle of numbers, then why have a presidential poll? You know, one knows which party is supporting what. Why not just declare a winner? Why go through this process at all? So it's, the process itself represents a very important stage in our democracy, when the top job of the land is being fought for, and is being fought for on the basis of ideology.
Meera ji, you know, traveled across the length of the breadth of the country. She spoke with a lot of lawmakers. What is the kind of response she got? I'm sure you must have, you know, also accompanied her. How was the response of the entire country when she met with them?
The response was overwhelming. It was full of enthusiasm, energy and fire. And therefore, we are very confident that many people, far too many people, are with us in this particular battle.
Do you also believe that there is a chances of cross-voting, because there are many people that are saying that there might be some people, you know, coming out, as there is no whip, as you know. There are many people, you know, who can come switches and, you know, sides and come and support Meera ji also. How do you see this?
Well, what we have done is, what my mother has done is, appeal to the vote of conscience, which is very necessary. I think this is, after a long time, this vote of conscience appeal has been made in this election, considering the grim scenario of the country today. And therefore, we are hopeful that people will listen to their vote of conscience and act accordingly.
My last two questions. What is the one thing that you want, you know, one should keep in his mind while casting, you know, his or her vote?
Well, simply that it should be a vote of conscience. It should be the principles and ideology that is represented in our composite culture, in our philosophy that is inherent in our land. And that is that philosophy that's going to fight all kinds of communal and caste forces.
And one last question, sir. What is the program of ma'am? Is she going to out somewhere to meet some people? And I'm sure she must have spoken to you. How is her mood today?
Actually, I haven't got a chance to speak to her. I'm speaking to you first. So I will, of course, I'll have a word with her. Of course, there's a lot of excitement. I'm sure people will come and meet her. And she's already in touch with everyone from the various states and regions.
Let's get you the latest on different parts of the country. I have our colleagues joining us live from Bangalore. We have Sagai Raj and we have Mohit Bhatt joining us live from Patna as well. Mohit, let me come across to you and talk about the decisive blow that the Congress party has actually got in this particular presidential race when they had their own ally, the JDU, that came out backing the NDA's. Okay, I will come back to you in a couple of moments. Some more breaking inputs coming in. Let's take a listen in.
एनसीपी की ओर से शरद पवार जी ने मीरा कुमार जी को स्वयं हस्ताक्षर करके और उनके फॉर्म भरने की प्रक्रिया में भी सहभागी होकर समर्थन घोषित किया है और एनसीपी के सभी विधायक एनसीपी के सभी एमपी हमने मीरा कुमार जी को ही वोट डाला है।
Of the Congress NCP, they're speaking out saying that it is Meera Kumar's candidature that they are supporting. So our colleagues from Bangalore, from Patna, as well as Kolkata are joining us right now. I will just come back to you. Stay with me, please. Let's get a quick input from what's happening in Kolkata first. I will come back to you, Mohit. Tapas, if you can hear me and the line is through, we've seen how Mamata Banerjee has tried to keep a very close eye on these presidential elections, right? And she has asked for voting of all the MLAs and MPs in Kolkata itself. Can you bring us up to speed with what's really happening? Okay, I think we have lost that link there from Kolkata. Sagai Raj, the question goes out to you of all the rumblings that are taking place in Karnataka. What's the latest? Sagai Raj, is my voice going through? Can you hear me? Okay. There seems to be an issue in the line.
Yes,
with the
I can hear you.
Okay,
now.
You can. So please go ahead. Tell us about the voting process that is underway right now.
Rajya Sabha members and 224 MLAs are voting here in Vidhan Sauda. The voting has begun as early as 9:30 in the morning, and we know very well that Karnataka will be a face-saving state for Meera Kumar, where the JDS and Congress have already declared that they will be backing Meera Kumar, and definitely this particular state will fetch a good number for a Congress candidate, and people are voting as early as 9:30, and we are expecting that the voting should get over by end of the noon. Back to
okay.
You.
Stay with us, please, Sagai Raj. Mohit, the question I was asking you, while the Congress, of course, received the decisive blow with JDU first, of course, backing Mr. Ramnath Kovind, but tell us about the meeting, if you have inputs, on Mr. Sharad Yadav, who had a meeting with Ms. Sonia Gandhi last evening, just a day before this presidential elections that is underway. What is it that the Congress and the JDU are discussing, even though at a time when we're speaking of this Mahagathbandhan, which could be in its own fighting a battle? Mohit, can you hear me? Mohit, is my audio going?
Yes, Akshay, could you please repeat your question?
Yes, my question to you was about the meeting that last evening Ms. Sonia Gandhi had with the JDU's chief.
Yes, Akshay, I can hear you. Please.
Yes, Chief Mr. Sharad Yadav. And just a day before these crucial presidential elections, tell us a little more in detail of what's happening between the Congress and the JDU.
Well, actually, it seems to be quite an embarrassing moment for the Congress here in Bihar. They are into the Mahagathbandhan, but then their ally, JDU, has clearly decided that they will be supporting Ramnath Kovind in these presidential elections. As I told earlier, that JDU had a meeting with all its legislators yesterday under the leadership of Chief Minister Nitish Kumar, and when the JDU leaders came out of the meeting, they clearly stated that we were briefed about the presidential elections process, and also they stated that they will be voting for Ramnath Kovind. And while this meeting was going on, there was another simultaneous meeting going on at RJD President Lal Prasad Yadav's place, where all the legislators of RJD were there, including Tejaswi Yadav, Tej Pratap Yadav, Lal Prasad Yadav. And when their RJD leaders came out, they had this official media soundbite, and they stated that they will be supporting Meera Kumar. So clearly the rift was clear between the RJD and the JDU, and Congress have been saying that that their ally, JDU, should support their presidential candidate Meera Kumar. But JDU have clearly made up their mind since Ramnath Kovind's name was being announced. Nitish Kumar clearly came out in open and said that they will be supporting Ramnath Kovind. And also this was the starting point of friction in the Mahagathbandhan. And yesterday also Sonia Gandhi met Sharad Yadav, but then also the issue of this presidential election, but then Mahagathbandhan was also discussed, because okay, we saw how the political situation is in Bihar, and this is a clear fallout of that. where JDU has clearly decided that they will be supporting Ramnath Kovind. RJD simultaneously had a meeting and they came out, they said that they will be supporting Meera Kumar. But okay. In all, it's quite embarrassing for the Congress that they are in the power here in Bihar, they are in the Mahagathbandhan, but still their ally JDU has decided to support the opposition candidate, that is our NDA's candidate, Ramnath Kovind.
Okay, stay with us. We'll also go across to our colleague reporting from Chandigarh. But a little later, Amit, I'll come to you. Let's get a quick update from Sagar Raj once again. Sagar Raj, if we go by the numbers, yes, it is a state of Karnataka that will give those big numbers to Ms. Meera Kumar. But overall statistics indicate that the fight is 70% for Kovind and about 40% for Ms. Kumar. So when you talk about victory in the election results, it's for anybody to guess on who will be the next president of the country anyway. Sagar Raj?
Absolutely, Akshay. Yeah, much before the battle has begun, the result is already clear, and this is just a formality which has begun. But probably when you are talking about Karnataka will definitely get good numbers for Meera Kumar, because it is, as I told you earlier, it is a face-saving battle for Congress. And if at all, if they have to get some good numbers, and this is a state that it can give the numbers. And talking about the council, definitely council have good numbers for BJP, where BJP MLC might go ahead and vote in favor of Ramnath Kovind. Apart from that, when you talk about the 28 MPs as well as 12 Rajya Sabha members and 224 MLAs, close to one vote of the MLA is around 131 value. The value of the one vote is 131 votes. So we need to wait and watch whether these numbers will definitely help Congress or it is going to be yet another losing battle for them. Back to you.
Absolutely. And also tell us about the opposition players over there in terms of the number of seats where the BJP and as well as the state, the JDS has in the state assembly. If we talk about the support that's going to be coming in for the other candidate as well, which is Meera Kumar, while of course Ramnath Kovind has the numbers, how is that really playing out in terms of other opposition players over there? Sagar Raj.
A former Prime Minister Devegowda has already announced that he will go ahead and support a Congress candidate Meera Kumar, and the JDS MLCs and MPs and MLAs will go ahead and be voting in favor of Meera Kumar. And talking about the BJP, they have already had a meeting early in the morning where they were, after the meeting MLAs have gone out and voted, and even Congress had a CLP meeting. After the meeting, Dinesh Gundurav spoke to us and clarified, and he has accepted that the battle is already over, and he has also went on to say that now after the presidential election there will be no control over Prime Minister Narendra Modi, because even a presidential office will be controlled, remote controlled by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in coming days.
All right, do stay with us, please. We'll go back to our colleague Mohit, but also in a couple of moments. But let's also now go across to Chennai, where my colleague Lokpriya is joining us live from with the latest of what's happening there in the state of Tamil Nadu. It'll be interesting to see, really, because we have seen how AIADMK continues to remain also very divided in this particular time where the party itself is concerned. But tell us about the others in the fray. You know, there is the DMK, then there is Vaiko, and there are so many others. How is it all really playing out in Tamil Nadu for the race for the presidential position?
Well, yes, we are coming to you live straight from the secretariat here in Chennai. The AIADMK is support of Ramnath Kovind. All three factions of the AIADMK are supporting Ramnath Kovind. So there is no surprise in that particular end. Though they are divided by factions, they are united by their choice in supporting the BJP's presidential candidate. When it comes to the DMK and the Congress, they are supporting Meera Kumar. So from Tamil Nadu, the numbers clearly are on the side of the AIADMK because of their majority in the Lok Sabha as well as here in the Tamil Nadu Assembly. And people like Vaiko do not even have numbers because they are not MLAs of the state. Thus, they are not able to vote. Remember, the MLAs here in the Assembly belong to the DMK, the AIADMK, the Congress and the IUML. So going by those numbers, clearly the support from Tamil Nadu is for Ramnath Kovind. It really depends upon the numbers at other parts of the country, whether Meera Kumar will be able to make it as a president. Here in Tamil Nadu, opposition leader M.K. Stalin and AIDMK faction O. Paneerselvam have cast their votes. Over 120 MLAs have cast their votes. The remaining of them are yet to cast. It is believed that the exercise will go on till about an hour's time, where all the 232 MLAs will vote here at the secretariat. DMK Chief Karunanidhi, due to his ill health, will not be voting for the presidential poll. Also, another MLA from Kerala has been given special permission to vote at the Tamil Nadu secretariat. So, all in all, 233 MLAs will be voting from the Tamil Nadu secretariat today for the presidential polls.
So, if we have to say a chunk of the votes, look, Priya, help us understand. One would imagine that from the state of Tamil Nadu, a chunk will actually go in for the NDA's candidate, Mr. Ramnath Kovind, because we've been discussing about the overall statistics. Experts continue to point out it would be a 70% there for Kovind, but just about 40% there for Kumar.
Definitely, yes, because here in the state itself, AIDMK accounts for a majority of MLAs. They have over the support of 130 MLAs. So in that sense, yes, the majority chunk of votes for Ramnath Kovind will be from the AIDMK camp, because they have pledged support to Ramnath Kovind. The three factions of the AIDMK, in fact, are in a race to be the number one to support BJP. So be it the OPS faction or CTV Dinakaran or EPS for that matter, all three of them are supporting Ramnath Kovind. DMK with its allies of 89 MLAs will be pledging support to Meera Kumar. But how much can Meera Kumar really muster the votes remains depending on the voting patterns in other parts of the country, whether there is going to be cross voting taking place. So all this will decide Meera Kumar's chance of winning. But going surely by the number games, definitely it is in the side of Ramnath Kovind.
Okay, stay with us please, Lokpriya. Mohit, if I can come back to you, we saw what the Congress president really had to say, calling this as a vote of conscience, a clash of ideas, a conflict of values. All of that the Congress has maintained, Mohit. Is there no resonation of that at all within the JDU? Is the JDU only coming out and voting because Mr. Ramnath Kovind has been the governor of Bihar and the chief minister said that he's had a cordial relationship? What about all that the Congress president also has had to say about the conflict of ideas, etc.?
Well, actually, since the name of Ramnath Kovind was announced by the NDA, JDU was the leader Nitish Kumar was the first one who went and congratulated him, and also he stated that he is supporting Ramnath Kovind not just as an NDA candidate, but because he has been associated with Bihar, he was the Bihar governor, and also he has personal relations with him. So clearly, JDU is supporting Ramnath Kovind, and these were the reasons that were given by Nitish Kumar. And since then, there were many proposals from the Congress side, many efforts from the Congress side to make sure that Nitish Kumar does not vote for Ramnath Kovind. Instead, he should vote for Meera Kumar. We saw how Ghulam Nabi Azad also came to Bihar and senior leaders of the Congress talked to him, but then he did not backtrack from his stance. He stated that JDU will vote for Ramnath Kovind, and yesterday also when this meeting took place at his place, all the MLAs came out and in one voice they stated that they will be voting for Ramnath Kovind. And Akshay, if we talk about the Bihar Assembly, 71 seats are there for the JDU, which is a huge number, and they all will be going to Ramnath Kovind. And then there are 53 seats with the BJP, and they are also be voting for Ramnath Kovind. So clearly, this number of 71 is very crucial if we talk about this election. And also, if we talk about the Mahagathbandhan unity, then JDU breaking away from it, and
correct,
also the United Opposition, he breaking away from it and voting for the NDA's candidate, that weakens the Mahagathbandhan that for 2019 also.
Okay.
So clearly, Congress wanted Nitish Kumar to vote for Meera Kumar, but then he did not backtrack from his stance. And
correct,
last night and yesterday, just hours before the presidential elections, they came out and they clearly on camera stated that
yes,
they will be voting for Ramnath Kovind.
But as the Congress said, it's important to put a fight and then make it a hard fight as well when it comes to this race. We leave it at that. I'm going to request all my colleagues, Mohit, Lokpriya, as well as Sagaraj, to stay with us. We're taking the short